Hey guys, welcome back to Outside with Shive. Today I'm at my buddy's where I did probably the first four videos. Well, not the first one, but the other ones consecutive after that. We're gonna split some ash he cut down a couple weeks ago. And probably only take 5 minutes, so I'm just gonna let her rip. No speeding up, no nothing. So if you stick with me, we'll get right to it.
This crotch piece is probably the toughest piece of wood that I've ever had on this splitter. The rugged split struggled a bit, but it came out on top in the end, as you'll see through the rest of the video here. This thing was a bear. I mean, got it stuck on the wedge twice, as you'll see. It just didn't want to cooperate, that's all.
Thank you.
this piece here, I wanted to split it, but ended up getting stuck on the wedge again, and we had to hit it off with the axe, and my buddy said he was just going to burn it the way it was, so we just let it go at that. Like I said, this whole crotch piece here was a big old pain in the butt. So that thing probably took just as long as it took to split the rest of the wood. This thing was a big pain in the butt, as you can see. Tell I'm not really used to being on this side of the splitter. Just not used to having other people helping, and let alone me not operating the splitter. But just one of those things, you know, you're used to doing things one way and then you end up doing another way. You can operate this splitter from both sides. It's just I'm not used to operating it from this side, that's all. This piece here, I knew the splitter would have a problem with the four-way. I mean, it didn't even really try, but that big old knot on the top there, it didn't want to push through. So once we got it back down, or back off the wedge, and just took the four-way off, and splitter in half, everything went pretty well, so.
not entertained?
This thing can't even split a piece of ash. We don't like those crotch pieces very good.
But one wasn't a crotch piece. It just had a knot in it.
Big old knot in her, though. And it's... Hell, I could sell this as, in my wood stand.
That's heating my house, pal.
All right, guys. I don't know if you guys remember these two bays. They were full of poplar. A buddy heats his pole, so he burned through two cord of poplar within 2 months of heating his pool. And then he had some, probably another cord and a half or so over here of oak that lasted twice as long as a poplar. So he's basically out of wood except for what he has in here and what we just split. So we need to get on this guy's wood too. So I'm sure you'll be seeing some videos on that. But that's all I got for you guys tonight. So again, if you like this type of stuff, hit that like button, leave a comment down below, and tell your friends. I'll see you guys in the next one.